mga kababayan, welcome to my channel, welcome to Laruan ni Obi-Wan. Just this afternoon, fresh out of Target, this is the Infinity Saga by Marvel Studios. This is the Odin figure, the All Father. The figure out of packaging, but before we discuss the figure, let me just say that this has got to be one of the most prettiest action figure boxes that I have ever seen from a Marvel Legends line. So if you ever get this figure, please do take care of your boxes, and if you so happen to chance on this figure and there are several on the pegs, choose the best one that you could keep as pristine as possible if you're going to take the figure out of packaging. So we have the figure. We have the basic Odin figure. This is the staff. We have an extra pair of hands and an extra head. So if you guys are missing any of the pieces that are mentioned or you see in this video, then you have to return your figure to Target. The other thing that I would consider as an accessory would be this gorgeous helmet. So this is not attached to the head of the figure, as I thought that it was attached to the first head of the figure and this was to be displayed as a separate piece. But since the helmet is removable, I think that it could be placed on this head too. So let's explore. Okay. So it's possible to display this helmet with this head piece. But I noticed that it is really a tight fit around this extra head. So I guess that this extra head is meant to be displayed separately without a helmet. So if you want an Odin figure without a helmet, then I think that you have to go to this head piece. But for the helmeted version, you have to go with this other head, because as you could see, the helmet fits on nicely to the figure and it's easy to put it on and take it off. Unlike the other head that came with the figure, as you could see, the diameter, the head circumference or diameter, I think is different. So this head, I think, is bigger, as evidenced by the tightness of this helmet with regards to fitting with this head. Now, the other thing that's really worthy to take a look at with this figure when you take it out of box would be the detail on the staff or slash spear of the Odin figure. As you could see, there is really a lot of detail that has been put into this spear piece. So let's discuss the most boring part of all, is with regards to articulation of the figure. So let's get through with it. So the head is on a ball joint. There is no ab crunch for this figure. We have a ball for articulation for the waist. As for the shoulder articulation, it is quite hindered because of the cape piece. But without this cape piece, we have rotation of the arms, sideways movement. We have a cut on the biceps for rotation. We have 2 points of articulation. For the elbows, we have rotation and a hinge for the hands. but the difference would be on the first pair of hands that is attached to the figure, the hinge would be on top of the wrist over here, instead of the more traditionally face of the wrist hinge. Okay, for the leg area, we have a cut on the thigh for rotation. We have 2 points of articulation or break for the knee. We have a hinge and a rocker for the foot, but it is hindered because of this piece on the boot area, which hinders a little the articulation of the foot. So that covers articulation for the figure. So just the base figure alone, this figure looks like it's a small figure, but actually let's measure it to be precise. So how tall does he stand? So this Odin figure stands at about 6.25 inches. So how does he measure with a Thor figure? So from possibly the same movie, I think. So this Thor figure, I think that is a 7-inch figure. So yeah, that is a 7-inch figure. And just to complete the picture, let's include Loki. So Loki stands at about 6.5. So this is how this Odin figure measures up or goes well with the other Marvel Legends figure of his own family. Okay, another thing out of the box, I was fiddling with this figure and thinking that somehow something was kind of off with the figure, especially in the shoulder area, because I tried to straighten this figure out by leaning the torso of the figure towards the right side. But later on, I realized that the way the plastic cape droops on the other side of the figure, on this side, it's lower than this side. So actually, it's an effect on the cape, giving you that some kind of scoliotic thing when you take your Odin figure out of packaging. But as you could realize, just take note that the flow of the cape is lower as compared to over here, which is higher, and this one is draped backwards. This cape is draped forwards. Those were my talking points for this figure. Let's go to the photos and the video shots.